Hey everybody, welcome to today's breakfast. My name is Kacie Star Long, and guess what? I am your host for today's breakfast. I want to thank you so much for joining me for today's broadcast. Now, if this is your first time ever watching one of my videos, I want to welcome you. So what I try to do each and every day is share a word from the Lord, and I call it today's breakfast because breakfast is supposed to be the most important meal of the day. And so I am really looking forward to sharing the word of God with you on today. So I'm just now leaving the gym, jumped in the shower, and so here I am. So I got my hair kind of like still in the flat twist. I hope I don't regret doing this video like this, but hey, we're family, right? We're family. And so since we're family, I'm just going to come just as I am today. So, all right. Well, good morning to you guys. Thank you guys so much for coming on in. Good morning to you, Kim. Good to see you. I'm going to jump right into the message for today. I won't be before you long, but before I do, I want to make sure you know that during the month of September, which is just a few days away, during our breakfast time, we're going to eat a proverb a day. So what that means is we're going to have a Proverbs challenge during the month of September. Now, I understand there are 31 Proverbs and there are 30 days during the month of September. So that means we're going to have to double up on that last day. But beginning next month, beginning the month of September, I'm going to be going through the book of Proverbs, and I'm going to pull out what God is saying to us based on the Proverbs. So I'm really looking forward to this. You know, the Bible talks about that in all thy getting, get wisdom, get understanding. And so really looking forward to going through God's word for our Proverbs challenge during the month of September. All right, you guys, I see you guys are all coming on in, which is awesome. Let's go ahead and talk about the topic for today. And I'm going to really use a lot of practical examples because I learned by illustrations. Part of our ministry here at Inspired Overflow, we are a teaching ministry. And so I just believe in teaching and using illustrations because I really believe that that breaks kind of like barriers in our minds when we can really receive practical illustrations and examples. Also, I want to thank each and every one of you for praying and for attending. Those of you that were able to make it to the singles night of refreshing this past Friday, we had a great time. God moved. And I'm so grateful for those of you that prayed and those of you that were able to come. We even had some married women come and bring their single friends. And I love that. I thought that was so awesome. So you guys, thank you so much for attending and thank you so much for praying. All right, let's get into the topic today. So as you can see on the title on the screen, we're going to be talking about renewing your mind. And I know we hear a lot about that in the body of Christ, but this is where I'm coming from today. Really in my prayer time, God has been speaking to me about the importance of having a renewed mind and really having a renewed mind that comes from really breaking the spirit of fear. God began to speak to me that many in the body of Christ, and I'm raising my hand because I've been having to deal with this too, that there are some things that God desires to do in your life. There's some things that God desires to do even in my life, but it's like God can't do it because our minds haven't caught up with what God wants to do. So let me break it down and explain it like this. I was listening to Creflo Dollar today while at the gym, and he basically began to share that everything that we need as believers, God has already given it to us. That when Jesus died on the cross, he died for our salvation, he died for our healing, he died for our prosperity. All of that is included in salvation. So all of the work was done over 2,000 years ago on the cross and through his resurrection. But a lot of times we have yet to receive and take hold of that. And it's really because our faith isn't there. So if you need healing, healing is already there for you. You got to take it by faith. If you need some money, if you need prosperity, you know, prosperity isn't just regulated to money, but maybe it's finances. God is a God of abundance. It's already there. You got to receive it by faith. And there are some things that God's been speaking to me, just even about ministry and just doors being open. And the Lord began to speak to me and say, Kacie, it's there, but you got to take it by faith. And so I began to speak to the Lord and say, you know, God, whatever is blocking it, I need for it to be removed. And God began to speak to me about the importance of renewing your mind, to really pray for your mind. So I'm praying for your mind today. I'm praying for my mind today that we will have the mind of Christ. That any barriers in your mind of doubt, unbelief, they will be broken now in the name of Jesus. God began to just show me just patterns in my life of how the spirit of fear really wants to just run in and wreak havoc. And, you know, when we think about the spirit of fear, I used to think about fear being like Halloween, spooky, scary, like, rah. You know, no, that's not how the spirit of fear operates. I'll give you an example of how the spirit of fear works in my life. About going to the gym. So sometimes like I'll go to the gym in the mornings, but in the evenings when I'm just kind of chilling, I would like to go to the gym in the evenings just to, I don't know, walk around the track or just to keep moving, you know, just to get my steps in, my calories burned, all of that. But there'll be a voice. No, you don't need to go to the gym. You need to stay at home. You know, what about if you go out, it'll be late and then you got to get up in the morning and then, you know, you won't be able to function during the day. And so I stay at home. And God began to show me that that really was a spirit of fear, that sometimes we convince ourselves out of doing stuff before we even get started. That maybe God's called you to put on an event, put on a conference. Maybe God's called you to go invite someone to church. But before you even think about going to ask them, the spirit of fear, the spirit of intimidation, the enemy sending you just kind of assumptions and lies, you've already convinced yourself, you know, no, I'm not going to do that. Maybe you feel God's calling you to start your business, to start attending classes, to take entrepreneurship classes so you can learn, to go back to school. But before you can even do that, before you can, you know, go to the registrar's office and sign up, here comes the enemy. Well, you know, what about the finances? What about who's going to watch the children? You know, maybe it's just not time yet. And so maybe you should just stay here. And so God began to show me that with that spirit of fear, it's just keeping us, those of us in Christ, just in a box where we are unable to break out and to break free. And so God has been speaking to me about the importance of you need to renew your mind. You need to renew your mind. You need to pray over your mind that you will begin to see things the way how God sees them, that every lie from the enemy, that the truth will be revealed. You know, one of the things that God began to speak to me about the truth of going to the gym, God is like, look, I've given you a mantle for exercise and fitness. I've called you to be healthy. Go to the gym. If you feel led to go to the gym, go to the gym. Trust me that I'm going to give you the energy. I'm going to give you the stamina to get up the next day in the morning to pray and do everything that you need to do. So I want to challenge you today. I want to challenge you today that whatever you feel led by the Lord to do, and you know what it is. You know when you're feeling prompted by the Lord to do something. You know it's going to bless you. It's going to bless others. When you have that unction to do something, that maybe it's going back to school. Maybe it's, you know, starting a business. Maybe it's writing a book. Maybe it's starting a ministry. Maybe it's telling someone about Jesus Christ. Maybe it's putting on a conference. When you get that unction, take a step and do it. Take a step and do it. Shut the door to the enemy. Close your mind to the enemy and say, you know what? I'm not going to listen to you. This morning after prayer, this morning during prayer, I just really felt led by the Lord to just download Apostle John Eckhart's Deliverance audio. So if you go to YouTube, and for those of you that are watching this via YouTube, I'll be sure to put the link in this message. And for those of you that are watching live, once this post, I'll go back and put the link. Apostle John Eckhart, he has a recording of a deliverance session. It's about 50 minutes long and it just walks you through deliverance. And I've done this a couple of times, but I really felt led by the Lord to just play the deliverance audio to really get this spirit of fear out. to get this spirit of fear out. And here's how fear works. It's like layers. And God began to show me that every time you do something that he's telling you to do, every time you decide to listen to the voice of God and not to the enemy, you're taking a layer off. That every time you decide to move forward, you're stepping on the back and the neck of the enemy. That sometimes fear isn't just like instantaneous like that, but it's you moving by faith. And each time you're like unwrapping a mummy cloth and you're getting more and more free. And God began to speak to me and say, look, every time you go to the gym and exercise, you're breaking free. Every time you tithe, every time you are disciplined with your money, You're getting free. Every time you sow a seed, when I tell you to sow a seed, Kacie, you're getting free. And so, you know, we got to really just pray over our minds, right? That we can be free and that we will not listen to the enemy. And, you know, one of the things that after I listened to the deliverance CD or deliverance audio, I got ready to go to the gym and I was brushing my teeth in the bathroom. And I heard the devil say, you know what? He's like, I'm not going anywhere. You think you bound off that spirit of fear? I'm not going anywhere. And I was brushing my teeth and I told the devil, I was like, you know what? Yes, you are. You're going underneath my feet. I am not tolerating you. I'm not playing with you. And some days we just got to be like that. Again, you know, we're renewing our minds. Devil, no, I'm not going to allow you to come in my vicinity. I'm not going to allow you to prevent me from reaching my destiny. The work Jesus did, it's already done. It's on the cross. I'm going to receive it by faith. And I'm not going to allow fear to prevent me from receiving anything that God has for me. Sometimes you just got to get buck with the enemy. Sometimes you just got to get buck with the enemy. At the end of next month, September the 27th, I am going to be doing an online Bible study, and we're going to be talking about the spirit of jealousy, comparison, pride. We're going to be pulling up those roots. And I got the information on the screen. It'll be over Facebook Live. It'll be at 7:00 in the evening on September the 27th. But one of the reasons why the Lord put this on my heart is because this is an area where the enemy tries to come in. And this has been an area where I've been like, look, I am not going to tolerate any spirit of jealousy, any spirit of comparison, any spirit of pride. No, you are not coming in. And so, you know, if you find yourself that the enemy's trying to come in your life through fear, if he's trying to come in through whatever it is, poverty, he's kind of trying to come into your life through sickness, whatever it is, I pray that there will be some holy boldness with me just sharing these stories, that there will be some holy boldness that will rise up on the inside of you. And you'd be like, no, I'm not accepting this. As a believer in Jesus Christ, the blood of Jesus is with you. You don't have to just accept what the enemy tries to put into our minds. The word of God says that, look, we don't fight against flesh and blood, but right, we fight against principalities and evilness and high places. But God also tells us in 2 Corinthians chapter 10, that he gives us the power to pull down strongholds. So those strongholds like, oh, you can't go to the gym. Oh, you can't lose weight. Oh, you can't eat healthy. Oh, you'll never get out of debt. Oh, you'll never break free. Oh, no, you can't sow that seed. You need that money. No, we pull down those strongholds, right? And we take every thought and we bring it into captivity in Jesus Christ. The work Jesus did on the cross when he died for you and he rose, that work is for you to be prosperous. That work is for you to live in abundance life. That work is for you to be happy and healthy in your soul. That work that he did already on the cross is for you to be delivered, for you to be delivered and not oppressed by the enemy. When you are dealing with fear, when fear comes in your life, that is oppression. That is a spirit of torment. But you know what? As believers, we don't have to just accept that spirit of torment. We can rise up. Right? We can rise up in the authority and the boldness of Jesus Christ. Luke 10 and 19 says that God has given us the power to trample on snakes and scorpions. The enemy belongs underneath your feet. But it's going to be really important for you to understand in your mind that you have the authority, that you have the power. So that's why we're talking about the importance of renewing your mind with the word of God. I mentioned last week that we are going to have a memory scripture each week. So each week we come together, we're going to memorize scripture. And so our scripture for this week, it's coming from Romans 12 and 2. right? And so it's talking about renewing our mind. And it says, do not be conformed to the pattern of this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind. We have to be transformed by the renewing of our minds. So Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you, God, for renewing our minds. I thank you, God, for renewing our minds, God, according to your word. Father, I thank you, God, Lord, for every viewer right now. I thank you, God, that you are breaking strongholds off of their minds in the name of Jesus. Father, I thank you, God, that you are revealing now imaginations, lies, God, that have been lobbed into their brains by the enemy. God, I thank you, Lord, for breaking open those lies right now. And God, I thank you, Lord, for replacing those lies with the truth, that God, you love them, that God, you have a plan, you have a purpose for them, that God, you have great things in store for them, God. I thank you, Father, that they will not be intimidated. They will not be hindered by the enemy, God, that wants to box them in. But I thank you, Father, God, that they will get a hold of your word, Father. I thank you, God, they will get a hold of your word, God, and that they will break free, God, to do all that you have called for them to do in the name of Jesus, Father. I pray, God, that they will renew their mind, God, according to your word. I ask, God, that you give them a hunger and a thirst for your word, Father. I pray, God, that scriptures will be open, God, that they will find out and understand who they are in you, God, in the name of Jesus. Father, I thank you, God, for a yoke-destroying anointing upon them, God. In the name of Jesus, Father, I thank you, God. No weapon formed against them shall prosper. I thank you, Father, that their minds, their hearts are covered with the blood of Jesus, that, Father, they will see themselves the way how you see them, God. They will see their futures, God, the way how you see them, Father. I thank you, God, for giving them steadfast resiliency, God. I thank you, God, for giving them endurance and stamina, Father, that, God, they will not stop, God, until they've reached, God, the destiny that you have for them, Father. Thank you, God, for teaching them, teaching their hands how to fight, their fingers for battle. I thank you, God, that, Lord, they'll rise up against the enemy, God, that they won't just allow the enemy to just come in and terrorize them, but, God, they will declare the word of God in the name of Jesus. I thank you, God, for showing them how to pull down every thought, God, and bringing it captive into the obedience of Jesus Christ, that, God, we're not going to just allow the enemy to litter our minds with junk, with untruths, God, with lies and unbelief. But God, we will be men and women of faith. We believe your word. We eat your word. We receive your word in the name of Jesus. Well, you guys, that's the message for today. That's what the Lord put on my heart today, to just really share about praying over your mind, asking God to renew your mind. My prayer today is that you will ask God to show you any lies, any untruths, you know, that you may have been believing. Today, and in my prayer time, I just had to just do some journaling and, you know, just kind of write down some things that I was believing. And I'll just share this just to be transparent, but I really felt like, in addition to going to the gym, that God was also calling me to just spend more time with him in my prayer time in the evenings. And that's been really hard. And so today God had me write down the list of the reasons why I don't want to spend time in the evening with the prayer, in prayer time with him. And so the first thing that I wrote, I was like, well, it's boring. I wrote that, you know, fear of missing out. I want to watch TV. I wrote out how I feel like in the evening it's my time and I just want to just relax. And, you know, I begin to just write down all this stuff. I begin to write down, you know, that God, sometimes it seems like there's no fruit in sitting in your presence. Come on, y'all. I'm just being real. I'm just writing this stuff down to the Lord. And so after I wrote that stuff down, I began to write the truth. Well, what does God's word say about spending time in his presence? That it's never wasted. That if you want to prosper, you spend time in the presence of the Lord. That God's word is healing. That God's word strengthens me. That God's word gives me endurance. God's word gives me stamina. That God's word is alive, it's sharp, it's powerful. You know, I began to just knock down all the lies and the untruths about spending time in his word with the truth that's in God's word about what happens when we get in his presence and spend time with him. And after doing that exercise, I didn't even really realize that I had been believing these lies. And these were just some lies, you know, in my head that, you know, okay, you know, if I spend time in the evening with the Lord, you know, it's going to be boring. You know, sometimes I'm not really sure what to do and all this kind of stuff. But I had to refute those lies with the truth of God. And so I shared that example with you that maybe you just need to get down and get a piece of paper and think about what are you thinking about and compare that with the truth of God. That sometimes even as believers, we don't realize that we've been thinking a lie. That maybe you've been thinking like, I can't exercise. I can't eat healthy. I can never be a vegetarian. That's for them. That's not for me. That's a lie. Who told you you can't do that? The lie that you can't go back to school and be successful. That time has passed, that you'll never get married. Who told you that? That's a lie from the enemy. That's a lie from the enemy. So I shared this message today about the importance of making sure that we renew our minds with the word of God. We renew our minds with the word of God. All right, you guys. Well, I've already shared with you that later in the month of September, we're going to have a special Bible study. I'm going to be doing these Bible studies once a month. And so our first session will be on, it's called Why Her? And we're going to be digging up the roots of jealousy, competition, and comparison. So if you ever ask God, why her? God, you know, what about me? Why her? If you ever ask God that question, we're going to be talking about really pulling up these roots of jealousy, comparison, and competition, especially in the body of Christ. Okay. Also, maybe you have a ministry or a church and you want to just get the information out to the community about what God is doing at your church. I want to invite you to please become a sponsor with us here at Inspired Overflow. In addition to doing these daily broadcasts, we are also a weekly Christian talk show that airs in the St. Louis area and also nationally. Okay. We are also heard nationally as well. All right, you guys. Well, I pray that today's broadcast has been a blessing. I will be back tomorrow for tomorrow's breakfast. Until then, have a good day. Be blessed. And all right. I'll see you tomorrow. Bye.